Hello and welcome. Thank you for joining the Advanced Google Calendar training for UC Berkeley. We will begin today's session by going into our settings in the upper right-hand corner. As a reminder, don't guess or memorize what the buttons do. Please always just hold your mouse over it and it'll tell you exactly what it does. So we're going to go to the gear in our upper right-hand corner that says Settings. We'll give that a single click and then we will go into our settings again. From here, some of the advanced settings that we'll talk about are one of my favorites, Speedy Meetings. By default, your meetings are set to 60 minutes. Of course, you can change individual meetings, but with Speedy Meetings, it will actually set it for a default of 50 or 20 minutes. This will encourage folks to allow for time to walk across campus or, you know, have time in between your meetings. We find that if you allow people to talk for 60 minutes, they'll talk for 60 minutes. If you give them 50 minutes to talk, they'll talk for 50 minutes. So the Speedy Meetings is an option. Another option that we have here is to show or not show your weekends. So hopefully none of you are working on the weekends, so you can choose to turn that off. You can also go into your default view. Perhaps you're the type of person who, when you first open your calendar, would prefer to see the day view or the month view. By default, it is set to week. You can also go ahead and customize your view. So I have a custom view here of 2 weeks. Perhaps you are the type of person who enjoys a 3-week view, so we'll go ahead and set it to that. Kind of fun if you type in your city and state or your zip code, and then choose Fahrenheit. The weather will actually show on your calendar. So again, you can type in your city and state or your zip code and then choose Celsius or Fahrenheit, and the weather will actually show directly on your calendar. So those are some of the more advanced settings. I'm going to go ahead and click Save in the bottom left-hand corner. Next to my name here, listed as UCB Trainer, there is a drop-down arrow. And remember, drop-down arrows always just mean you have choices. So when I click that drop-down arrow, I can go ahead and go to Notifications. So Notifications will actually allow me to set or change my default event reminders. So right now, I have my event reminders set to a pop-up at 15 minutes before my meeting, and an email at 15 minutes. So pop up at 5 and an email at 15. This means by default, unless I change it, which I can do for each individual meeting, unless I change it, I will have these two reminders at the very least. I'm going to go ahead and include another one. Knowing myself as I do, I would also prefer a 30-minute email as well. So this is your default reminder. Once again, you can always change that per individual meeting. You would probably want to make sure that all of your email reminders are on. This is a personal choice. They are on by default. So that means when I get notification of a new, changed, canceled, or event responses, I'll get that email. Those are on by default, but you can adjust them as necessary. As always, I'm going to go ahead and click Save in the bottom left-hand corner. Another advanced option, remembering, drop-down arrows always mean I have choices. If I click the drop-down arrow next to My Calendars, I can actually create a new calendar. So perhaps I want to create one for a project that I'm working on with other professors or university officials. There could be any number of reasons why you would want a separate calendar other than your default calendar. So I'm going to go ahead and click Create New Calendar. And really, all I have to do is give it a name, and then, of course, who do I want to share it with? I'm going to go ahead and call this University Project Calendar. Some colleagues of mine are working on a particular calendar, or a particular project. So I give it a name, and then, of course, at the bottom, who do I want to share it with? So I am working on this project with David, and I'm also working on this project with John. Now, different from sharing my calendar, it's probably a good idea to make at least one other person the owner of this calendar. So I'm going to give David that permission. Allowing him to make changes and manage the sharing of this calendar will essentially make him a co-owner. we don't need John to be a co-owner, but we do want him to be able to add items to this calendar. So make changes to events, kind of a misnomer. He can add, delete, or change events on this calendar. So he can manage this calendar. So David and I are the co-owners in this case, and John is just making changes to the events. Again, that includes creating and making any changes. So I've created my calendar. I've given it a name. I've decided who I want to share it with, and I will go ahead and click Create. Now, as I create an event on my calendar, we're going to call this a project meeting. And rather than putting it on my calendar's UCB trainer, I'm actually going to put it on the university project calendar. I'm going to go over to the right, and of course I will invite John, and I will invite David. And I do need to also invite myself. So keep in mind that you do need to invite yourself because you're putting it on the calendar. So UCB. Okay, so I have added myself and David and John, and I'm going to go ahead and just click Save. So remember, whenever you have a drop-down arrow, it always means you have choices. So that drop-down arrow will show me all of the calendars that I have access to add anything to directly because somebody gave me a permission or because I created the calendar itself. Everything is about permission in the Google Calendar. I'll click Save in the upper left-hand corner, and then, of course, I will send out my invitations. So I have on the left my university project calendar. It's a little too close to my own calendar, so I'm going to go ahead and give that a click, and I'm just going to make it red just for visibility. And so I see it here on the left, my project calendar. With one click I can turn that project calendar on, with one click I can turn it off. And of course there are many different ways you can add something to your calendar. So if I wanted to add this for Monday, I could go ahead and single click. I'm going to call this project meeting. And again, instead of putting it on my calendar, I'm going to go ahead and put that on the project calendar. If I wanted to invite anyone, I would click edit event, and then I could invite folks. So I'm going to go ahead and just create that event. And again, the university project calendar is in red. My calendar is in blue, easily identifiable. If the colors are too close, I can click the drop-down arrow next to my name, and I'm going to go ahead and make it a dark green. The color is always for contrast, whether I'm looking at my calendar, whether I'm looking at someone else's calendar. And then again, I can click on the university project calendar to turn it off, and I can click on it again to turn it on. So just another advanced feature that we have there. In the upper right-hand corner, because I did have a setting where I had a three-week calendar, I can go ahead and look at that, and that is my custom calendar, and I can still choose my day, my week, my month, and then I just have the three-week custom option because that is what I chose in my setting. And then if I go to today, I will see at the top of my calendar, because I chose to show that, I will see the upcoming events. And I could go to the different weeks by clicking the arrows. And then, of course, you can always click today. Now, one of my favorite advanced features, again, a drop-down arrow. If I hold my mouse without clicking over the drop-down arrow on the left, it says Quick Add. So as the name suggests, it will quickly add an event to my calendar. This is usually used for I'm really not intending to invite anyone else. It's really just for me. So I'm going to go ahead and quickly add that I need to make calls next Tuesday at 9 a.m. And I'm going to go ahead and press enter. So I need to make calls next Tuesday at 9 a.m. So when I click to next Tuesday, it has added it to my calendar here. It went with my default, which is my speedy meeting, so it went from 9 to 9:50. and it knows that next Tuesday is the 24th. So again, you're just using your keywords. I can say dinner with David next Friday at 7 p.m. at Morton's. And when I press enter, it knows that next Friday, if I scroll down, next Friday is the 27th, and so it lists my event here. Again, it takes my default of my speedy meeting. Now, I would have to invite David for him to know that we are having dinner. But again, the quick add is exactly what it sounds. It is a way to quickly add something to your calendar. Now, when I'm searching, if I have created an additional calendar, I do want to be cognizant of any search that I might use. So if I type in the word project because I'm looking for my project meeting, I'll notice that the results actually show up in red and green. That's because on the left, I'm actually still showing the project calendar itself, as well as my own. So when I click once on the university project calendar, the red goes away, and I'm just looking at my calendar, which is green. So be cognizant when you're searching, how many other calendars do you have on? If I have Mimi's calendar on as well, and she had anything with the word project, it would be listed as well. So just keep that in mind. If you do a search and you notice different colors, it is most likely that you have the other calendars turned on. So remember, you do have some really fun things that you can do in your Google Calendar. Last thing we're going to do is we're going to go back into our settings in the upper right-hand corner, and we're actually going to talk about labs. So labs are where Google's really still trying to experiment. So these are some things that are sort of still beta settings. Google's deciding, do people want to use them? Do they work? They're still slightly experimental. So one that I have enabled here is hide morning and night. I don't need to see the area cluttering up my calendar from 3 a.m. I don't work those hours. So I'll show you how that works. The hide morning and night lab is very popular. Scrolling down just a little bit more, some of you might enjoy the year view. It'll allow you to see the entire year, as the name suggests. I also really enjoy the jump to date. It allows me to go to a date in the future very quickly instead of scrolling. Another one that has been very popular with your colleagues at UCB is next meeting. It'll show a countdown clock on your right-hand side. My next meeting is in 2 hours 24 minutes, 2 hours 23 minutes, etc. And then there might be those of you that that work closely with folks in other time zones, other professors, other individuals at universities in different time zones. So the world clock is very popular as well. It'll show you all the time zones you need to keep track of over on your right-hand side. I'm going to go ahead and click Save to save my changes. So over on the right, I see some of the labs that I turned on. If I click on the year view, I can go ahead and click Go, and it shows me 2012. I'm going to click back to calendar in the upper left-hand corner. You can see 2013 if you need to. Here's my jump to date. If I wanted to go to August 4th quite quickly, I could do that instead of scrolling. So I can click jump to August 4th. And then here's my next meeting. Again, my next meeting is in 2 days and 4 hours, it looks like. And then my world clock. The world clock, you can go ahead and set up the time zones you are most interested in. So I'll click on settings at the very bottom. And I'd like to keep track of, as I scroll down, I'd like to keep track of the time in Winnipeg. Perhaps I have a colleague at a university there. And I'm going to go ahead and click Save. And so now I'm keeping track of the Winnipeg time as well. So highly customizable. Again, your Google Calendar is what you make it. So going into the settings and then the labs that we just looked at will allow you to customize and personalize your experience. The other lab that I'd like to show you how it works, we said was hide morning and night. So I see a little option here. It says drag to hide that time range. So if I don't want to see the wee hours of the morning, I can click and drag and I can hide. I usually start around 6 a.m. So I'm going to hide from 12 a.m. to 6 a.m. And so now it's hiding those times. and I try to leave the office by 5, but that doesn't hardly ever work. So we're going to go ahead and click and drag. That's my morning. I'm going to scroll down a little bit to adjust my evening hours. So I try to get out of the office around 6 p.m. So now you'll see as I'm scrolling, it tells me it's going to hide from 6 p.m. To midnight. So that is the hide morning and nights. And again, that was a lab that we turned on. If I do need to see those times, maybe I do have some evening appointments I need to keep track of. Hovering my mouse over that, it tells me click to show from 6 p.m. to 12 a.m. So it literally is just hiding it. It's not getting rid of it altogether. And again, as a point of reference, drop-down arrows mean you have choices. If you're not sure what something does, just hold your mouse over it without clicking, and it will tell you exactly what it does. So thank you so very much for joining us for our advanced session today. We hope you enjoy all the features and benefits of your new Google Calendar.